The Philippine Stock Exchange disputes the tax bureau's findings that it incurred over 189 million pesos in tax deficiency in 2017. In a disclosure, the PSE said the assessment involves alleged deficiencies in various taxes, including income tax, value-added tax, and expanded withholding tax. The local bourse added it will challenge the BIR's assessment and will take legal action for its cancellation. Going now through some corporate stories, the First Philippine Holdings Corporation is earmarking 80 billion pesos for its capital expenditures this year. Much of the said capex will go to the Lopez-led company's energy arm. This year's capex is higher than the 51 billion pesos in 2022. It will be funded through a combination of debt and internally generated funds. The firm's first-gen corporation is eyeing to lead efforts to transition to regenerative energy sources. Its construction arm, First Balfour, will join the North-South Commuter Railway project with its Hong Kong partner, Leighton Asia. Meanwhile, a subsidiary of Enrique Razon's Prime Infrastructure is supplying condensate to an Abu Dhabi firm. Prime Energy signed a deal with ADNOC AGT to supply the resource until February next year. Prime says the move establishes its force in the global petroleum industry. The company is part of the Malampaya Consortium and holds a 45% stake in the gas project. Finally, Universal Rubina Corporation announces its acquisition of the idle sugar machinery equipment of a mill in Batangas Province. URC says the facilities of the Central Azucarera Don Pedro Incorporated will be used to expand its sugar mill in Balaya. The food manufacturer says this will help provide jobs for sugar farmers displaced from the CADPE's closure in January. A new motorcycle taxi app is entering the local markets. Jervis Manahan is on the line to tell us more about Move It. Jervis, what is this about?
Yes, Arika, motorcycle taxi Move It has launched their app today, Tuesday. Move It aims to service the motorcycle riding public in Metro Manila. Currently, it has 6,500 riders available for bookings in a large part of the capital city. It promised to professionalize habal-habals while offering faster bookings and hygienic services. It is poised to serve more than 100,000 customers in the metro. Move It utilizes the technology of Grab but remains separate from the app. It is now available in the App Store and the Google Play Store. Rika.
Jervis, I just have one question. You mentioned that this is just an app, but really just an upgraded app that we have. But Move It is currently still on the technical working group being deliberated by the government. Is that right?
Yes, but it is already offering their services. So if you download the app, you can already book the services.
All right. Thank you so much, Jervis Manahan, reporting for us. The Philippine government is eyeing to speed up the process for the construction of its projects amounting 9 trillion pesos. Jackie Pascual is on the line for more. Hi, Jackie.
Hi, good afternoon, Rica. The Anti-Red Tape Authority plans to streamline the processes for the construction of the 194 infrastructure projects worth 9 trillion pesos. The Marcos administration recently approved the projects, which include railways, expressways, hospitals, airports, and more. At ARTA's 5th anniversary event in Manila, ARTA Secretary Ernesto Perez announced it will create a joint memorandum circular with NEDA and DICT to speed up the issuances of government permits and other documentary requirements for the so-called high-impact infrastructure flagship projects. Perez said this will ensure that the projects go smoothly without unnecessary bureaucratic delays. He said that the circular will expedite and prioritize the issuance of permits, licenses, clearances, and authorizations required for the projects, eliminating unnecessary red tape. He adds that expediting the processes is possible, as they have already done this in some sectors in the first five years of ARTA. One major accomplishment, he said, is in the telco sector, where they managed to streamline the process in the construction of the shared passive telecommunications tower infrastructure, as well as fiber poles, ducts, cables, and other telco facilities. Perez said that permits to construct towers and others are now down from 13 to 8. Documentary requirements are dropped from 86 to 35. And the average processing time, he said, was cut from 241 working days to now 16 working days. ARTA now plans to do this in other key sectors, including the energy sector and other industries that need a boost in the application or in the building process. And that's the latest. Erika, back to you.
Thank you so much, Jackie Pascual, reporting live.